السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته أديت من السلام يا دمان بلو بديك في سنيسان ومعلم محمد أمين بره إن حالي وحان قادم لي سواحلي عشيك أن درستي سواحلي أيضا ربنا إنا مرضا به مراجع وحير أو كوركشن أو سمينا حالي كاميرا دا حمد سادة كيسين به قرمتو دا نغتك تكيسي مركا دالما ينسفي عن لسكم أركينا عشيك سفع الممغن مركا عشيك يا مرلوات مراجع وسمينا إن شاء الله تعالى وحنا وقدرينا كبو شوعا وحاني وحان قادرينا كسواهيلي يا إنجليش We have said that last time we have learned the same lesson, but because of the problem of the camera, it was invisible. So that's why I'm now doing the correction. I'm now repeating that lesson so that you see it clear and you hear very nice for my voice. So we have said that nyakati. Of all about nyakati, everybody have to pronounce nyakati, nyakati, which means tense, tense, tense. Nyakati means tenses. So number one, let us take wakati, wakati uliopo, wakati uliopo. We say that wakati uliopo. Wakati uliopo means present continuous tense. Present continuous tense. That's called wakati uliopo, means present continuous tense. So in present continuous tense in English, it takes ing. But here in Kiswahili, it takes na. Instead of ing, it takes na, na. That na stands for ing. So we have said that wakati uliopo. Let's go to the second. We have said also here, wakati, wakati uliopita, uliopita, wakati uliopita, li. We have said also the next, the second, it's called wakati uliopita. Wakati uliopita means past continuous. Wakati uliopita means past tense. The past tense is called wakati uliopita. And it takes li instead of ed. Instead of ed, it takes regular verb, it takes ed. And irregular verbs, it takes the other issue of irregular. So, like shown, drown, ground, all those. So, wakati uliopita, it takes li instead of ed. Ed, it takes li. Wakati uliopita means past tense. Past tense. So let us go to the third. Wakati. Wakati ujao. Wakati. Wakati ujao. Which takes ta. Which takes ta. The last, we have said that number three here is wakati ujao. Wakati ujao means future. Future tense. Future tense, which takes ta instead of shall and will. Instead of shall or will, it takes ta. That means that ta shows you that this tense is for future tense. So wakati ujao means the future tense. And wahanere nyakati angadane hale, nyakati wangushagne, nyakati wahanere wa tenses ka. Number one, wahanere wakati uliyobo. Wakati uliyobo mi'nayadu hawe, وقت حاضرك فعلك وقت نعيه وقت حاضرك الدكتور هلا وقت اليوبو وانجليز كانوا يقولوا present continuous tense وقت حاضرك فعلك صعود مركز أسمعين يسألوا هلا وقت اليوبو وحنا لو قرنا يا أرجع قط به نا نا داس إن يا هذا أيوة الشيء إذا والشيء إنه فعل كيس واحد صعود أي إن جي قرنا يسأل بود بدل كي إنجليز كأي إن جي وقدر يعيد حلقة يسأل نا وقت اليوبو الله كان لما تحاول وقت اليوبيتا وقت اليوبيتا وحاول وقت اللي جسوا تجي ووقت اللي جسوا تقول لي جميل وقت اللي اسمح لو قرنا هو قادنا يا ال اي لي ايو قادنا يا ال اي وقادنا يا معنى هذا المحاول وقت هراء اللي جسوا تقول ايو شيء اي دي مش انجليز كقاطو لما كسر دعوة قدام بيو حنير وقاتي وجاو وقاتي وجاو وحلا وقتي مستقبل وحنا ولي الجاري وحنا لو قرت تا تا ده معنى هذا حاول نتا اند كيشو بري وان بحي دونا نتا كوجا كيشو بري يعني ما دونا تا ده وحي تمام يسا وحي نادولي جاري شل يو ويل مش لو استعمال لا ولا استعمال يا اوكي عشان كده كاوي هذا أنا قادنا لما رفي كويت لما روان أنا قادنا وحن قادنا هنا مركز لما روان أوها وكاتي أوليوبو وكاتي قفل بو وكاتي وقتي أوليوبو وقتي أولي وقتي هذا جو أوليوبو وكاتي أوليوبو وقادنا هنا نا معنى هذا محاوية present معنى هذا محاوية present continuous present continuous tense وكاتي لغابهم حوالي present continuous tenses مفانو توصالي مفانو عمر انا اندا عمر انا اندا سكوني عمر انا اندا سكوني This is the mfano. Mfano means example. So we have said that wakati uliopo means present continuous tense. So we have said here mfano. Mfano means example. Umar anaenda sokoni. Umar anaenda. Umar is going to the market. Umar. Umar is going to the market. Umar is going. Umar is going to the market. Umar is going to the market. We have said here, Umar anaenda. The word a ni personal pronoun. That's called third person singular. Third person singular a stands for he or she, ama it. So a stands for those. Third person singular a means third person singular. That's personal pronoun. Na is ing. It shows that this thing is present continuous. So we have said Umar anaenda sokoni. Umar is going to the market. Umar is going to the market. Now here, this sentence of English, it shows that you recognize or realize that this is continuous tense, a present continuous tense, because it has ing and also it has is, which is the auxiliary verb or helping verb, which shows that this sentence is now things happening now. It's an action happening now. So we have said that Umar anaenda sokoni. Umar is going to the market. Anda means going, sokoni is the market. So a is the third person singular. Instead of saying he, we use a. You see? Instead of she, we use a. Na is ing. I wish simply you have understood these things. Let's go to the second. Mama. Mama yangu. Ana pika, sio biga, pika. Mama yangu anapika chakula. So the second example is mama yangu, my mother anapika chakula. My mother is cooking food, anapika. Last night we have said here G, it was not G, instead of K, we made it G, not G. Biga means to beat, but this one is to cook. So you have to realize that pika. Mama yangu anapika chakula. My mother is cooking food. My mother is cooking food. My mother is cooking. Piga means to cook. My mother is cooking. Chakula is food. So we have said that mama yangu, my mother, anapika chakula. Mama yangu anapika chakula. My mother is cooking food. Mama yangu, this mama yangu, my mother. Ana is the third person singular, na ing. Pika means to cook, chakula is the food. So we have said that the mother is cooking. My mother is cooking food. My mother is cooking food. Which shows this is the present continuous tense. Okay, let's go to the third, which we have said that mwalimu ana wa fu fundisha. Mwalimu ana wa fundisha
Mwalimu anawafundisha wanafunzi. Wanafunzi. Mwalimu anawafundisha wanafunzi. Mwalimu anawafundisha wanafunzi. Mwalimu means the teacher. Anawafundisha is teaching the students. The teacher is teaching the students. Mwalimu anawafundisha wanafunzi. Mwalimu, the teacher, anawafundisha teaching the students. The teacher is teaching the students. Simple as that. Oh, okay. Waxaan jira habeen oo waxaan qaadanay 10 kan. Wuxuu gaaw kamerada naga halaysnayd iyo mugdi mugdi jiray dartay aan dib ugu soo celiyay. Waxaan qaadanaynaa nyakati. Nyakati waqtiga waxa la waa tenses-ka. Tenses-ka waqtiyada. Waqtiga hadda joogo haadirka ah, waqtiga laga soo tagay, waqtiga aan la gaarin. Saddexda waqti. Waxa la nyakati. Tenses luqadda Ingiriiska. Waxaan jira wakati uliyobo. Wakati uliyobo waxa la waqtiga hadda la joogo, waxa hadda dhacay. Ficilka hadda waqtiga la joogo waxa la waqtiga haadirkana waxa la wakati uliyobo. Waxaan lagu gartaa na'i ay qaadataa. Present continuous tense way. Mufano tusaale. Mufano maxaa way? Tusaale. Umar wilka la yiraahdo ana enda wuxuu u socdaa sukuni. Umar suuqa u socdaa. Umar now is going to the market. Umar ana enda sukuni. Umar is going to the market. Umar suuqa u socdaa. Tusaalaha labaad waxaan yiri maama yangu hooyo anapika waxay karinaysaa chakula cunto. Hooyo waxay karinaysaa cunto. She is now on the process of cooking the food. Maama cuntaday karinaysaa markeeda. Cuntadii walaaqaysay ku karinaysaa. Marka waxaad leedahay maama yangu hooyadii ama hooyo anapika waxay karinaysaa chakula. Habeenoon waxaan qaadanay biga wax la yiraahdo. Ji baan ka dhignay keydaas. Jidaas micnaheedu waa qaraacitaan laakiin pika haddana waxay noqonaysaa karinta pika way. Maama yangu anapika chakula. Hooyo waxay karinaysaa cunto. Okay. Tusaalaha saddexaad waxaan qaadanay mwalimu macalinkii ana wafundisha wuxuu wax baraya wanafunzi ardadi. Mwalimu macalinkii ana wafundisha. Fundisha waa baritaan teaching way. Ana wafundisha wuxuu baraya wanafunzi ardada. Wanafunzi maxaa way? Waa ardadi. Fundishana waa baridi. Mwalimuna waa macalinkii. Waa third person singular. Na'na waa ang di. Ficilkii socday u sheegaysa. Marka waxaan nidhi mwalimu macalinki ana wafundisha wuxuu wax baraya wanafunzi ardada. Ajirkeena waa noocaas insha allahu tacaala. Waxaan markaa kusii soconno tusaalooyin kale aan qaadano. Let's go ahead with the second examples aan qaadano. Slowly waxaan ku jirnaa wakati uliyobo oo ahay present continuous tense. Let us say babam. Papa ana Papa anakuja leo. Papa anakuja leo. Papa anakuja leo. Papa anakuja leo. Meaning how it? Papa means father is coming today. Father is coming today. Father is coming today. Abe manta yu imanaya. Papa anakuja leo. Abe manta imanaya. Usoso odawa is going to come. Father is coming today. The father is now on the way coming to home. So, huyu anasema kwamba papa anakuja leo. That means, papa ako njiani. Papa ako wapi? Ako njiani. Anatembea kwa njiani, anakuja kwa nyumbani. Kwa usoso odawa, utoto kusojira usoso odawa. Sasa papa is on the way coming to home. So, father is coming today. Papa anakuja leo. Papa abe anakuja uimana ya leo manta. Abe manto imana ya. Leo mhawe? Leo means today. Kuja means to come. Papa ni father. Ana a in third person singular. Na is ing. So the father is coming today. Father is coming today. Next. Huyu
ana nitukana. Huyu ana nitukana. Huyu ana nitukana. Mean huyu ana nitukana. This one is insulting me. This huyu means this. Somebody next or anything that is next to you. A singular thing which is next to you. So huyu is now it's used for a human being. So huyu, this ana nitukana is insulting me. This one is insulting me. This one is insulting me. This one is abusing me. This one is abusing me. So huyu means this. Ana ni it stands for me. Ni tukana. Tukana means abuse. So this one is abusing me. This one is abusing me. So huyu ana nitukana means this one. Did I say this one? This one is insulting me. This one is insulting me. This one is insulting me. Who you this one? Ana ni tukana. This one is insulting me. Who you ana ni tukana yani? Who you ana ni tuzi? Mutu who you ana ni tuzi? Mutu who you ana ni tuzi? Qofkan wi ayna ya. Mutu who you ana ni tuzi? Kusema this person is insulting me. Who you ana ni tuzi? This one is insulting me. Okay. Let's go to the third. Let's go to for example. Mutu yule ananipoteza. Mutu yule ananipoteza. Mutu yule ananipoteza. That person mutu ni person yule that ananipoteza is losing me. You see? That person is making me to lost. So that person ananipoteza. That person is making me is getting me lost. So that person is now maybe somebody is misleading somebody. So if somebody misleads you means to poteza means losing. So that person is losing me. That person is losing me. Is making me out of the way. So somebody tells you he misleads you. So means that person is misleading me. That person is misleading me. It's making me lost, is losing me. So, mutu yule ananipoteza. Let us go. Dada yangu anacheza mpira. Dada yangu anacheza mpira. Means dada yangu, my sister is playing football. So dada means sister yangu, my sister anacheza. Cheza means to play. Mpira ni football. So my sister is playing football. Dada yangu anacheza mpira. Okay, this is all about our lesson today. Let me translate or interpret to Somali. For those who don't understand English, let me go to Somali now. Let me turn the lesson to Somali. So I interpret or translate to Somali language so that also they could be with us. Waxaan irin yaakati. Waxaan soo qaadanay tenses-ka waqtiga. Tense aan sheegnay. Baba anakuja leo. Baba macnaheeda aabe anakuja wuu imaanaya leo maanta. Aabe maanta imaanaya. Baba anakuja leo. Meesha si fiican loo fahmo. Ereyga a wuxuu u dhigmaa waxaa aad baasan singular laba saddex qof midkooda laba qof oo ka maqan maxaa nira qofka ka maqan oo mufradka waxaa lahay asaga iyo ayada meesha ayada asaga isticmaal lahayd aadaas aan isticmaalay ingiriiska waxa isticmaalaya she iyo he laakiin kiswaxiil wuxuu isticmaalayaa a ay isticmaala waa ta waa hal qof oo naga maqan dadka naga maqan waxaa la taad baasan singular a ah loo isticmaala he ama she labadaba loo isticmaalaa nadaas waxay u dhiganta ficilka markuu joogo fax dhacayo ing ingiriisku ka qaato ficilka marka dhacaya waxaa loo isticmaalaa na kuja waa imaatinki leona waa maanta leo hadda maxaa waxaa leo maanta wey leo ni alhamisi maanta waa khamiis leo ni ljumua maanta waa jimco leo ni jumamosi maanta waa sabti leo waa maanta marka waxaan yidhi baaba aabe ana kuja wuu imaanayaa leo maanta okay father is coming today aaba maanta imaanaya huyu kani ana nitukana wuu icaynaya kani wuu icaynaya huyu macnaha waxaa hal qof oo kuu dhow aad leedaa kan waxaad leedaa huyu kani ana nitukana wuu icaynaya kani wuu icaynaya nidaas waa adiga kuusoo noqonaysa aniga aad leedahay huyu kani anahi ni as tukana wuu icaynaya tukana waa cayni kani wuu icaynaya okay this one is insulting me symbol mutu yule qofkaasi mutu waa qof yule ka fog mutu yule qofkaasi ana nipoteza wuu iluminaya qofkaasi wuu iluminaya mutu yule qofkaasi ana nipoteza wuu iluminaya poteza means losing so that person is losing me is making me is getting me lost wuu iluminaya qofkaasi wuu iluminaya mutu yule qofkaasi ana nipoteza wuu iluminaya okay dhaadha yangu walaashay ana jeza waxay ciyaaraysaa mpira dhaadha yangu ana jeza mpira cashirkeena maanta intaas ku egyahay insha allahu tacaala I request everyone to subscribe. Please subscribe this lesson if you are new and ring the bell. Like it, comment and share it. Please. Balanteenu waa inaad subscribe saartaan, kambalelka riixdaan, share garaysaan, like, comment and soo bixisaan insha Allah. Adoo mahadsan tihiin, cashirka cashirka xigo, waxay naga tagayaa sidaa iyo nabadgelyo, Allahna ha inay fudeeyo. Insha Allah kuwax kale faa'iidana Allah naga dhigo. Assalaamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.